Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Labrik. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received today a number of royal family members and officials, where he discussed with them a number of topics that interest citizens. His Royal Highness affirmed the government's keenness to respond to public opinion issues and topics that reflect the citizens' interests, stressing that fulfilling the citizens' needs is the responsibility of every official. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister noted the government's keenness to achieve the citizens' aspirations, adding that it is the government's duty to develop the country and achieve the requirements of its citizens at all levels. His Royal Highness highlighted the government's interest in enhancing quality and competency in the services provided to citizens and strengthening performance indicators across sectors. His Royal Highness affirmed that the government's efforts are ongoing in following up with the needs and aspirations of citizens and setting up service projects across the kingdom. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Ghadibiya Palace the Thai advisor to the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Chaisiri Annamarn, who is currently visiting the kingdom with a delegation of a number of Thai economic and cultural figures. During the meeting, the outstanding bilateral relations and means of developing them on all fields were discussed. His Royal Highness stated that the friendship relations and cooperation between Bahrain and Thailand are witnessing a continuous growth and are based on a history of understanding and respect. He noted the kingdom's keenness on consolidating further cooperation fields with Thailand and to bolster them for the common interest of the two countries. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister welcomed the Thai delegation, whose visit comes in light of the two countries' efforts to bolster bilateral cooperation, affirming the importance of such visits and meetings in increasing cooperation. His Royal Highness hailed the efforts of the Thai community in Bahrain and their role in supporting the development march in the kingdom, highlighting their competency that gained them the appreciation of the people. For its part, the Thai delegation expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for his continuous support to developing bilateral relations, asserting the Thai people's appreciation of His Royal Highness's efforts in bolstering relations. Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, the STW, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, honored the winners of the Young Bahrain Entrepreneurial Excellence Award in its 13th session at the Council's headquarters in Rafah. Her Royal Highness affirmed the Council's keenness to adopt initiatives, plans, and programs that support women's advancement in various fields. She also expressed the Council's keenness to work within the national system in order to activate the potential of Bahraini women and strengthen their ability to establish a sustainable private enterprise. Her Royal Highness noted the contributions of Bahraini entrepreneurs in the national economy and their ability to launch innovative projects. She expressed the Council's appreciation to all the pioneering projects participating in the award's 13th session. Her Royal Highness added that the launch of the award comes from the Council's belief in the importance of supporting young Bahraini competencies in entrepreneurship and highlighting their efforts in this vital field. She expressed appreciation to all national efforts that contributed in supporting this initiative and highlighted the initiatives and programs of Temkin that support the participation of women in the labor market. Her Royal Highness expressed thanks and appreciation to the judges of the award, headed by SCW member Sheikh Hissa bint Khalifa Al Khalifa. The SCW Secretary General Halal Ansari gave a brief presentation on the progress made by the award since its launch in 2011. For his part, Chairman of the Board of Directors of Temkin, Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa, affirmed Temkin's keenness to strengthen partnerships with the SCW under the leadership of Her Royal Highness Princess Sabiqa, hailing the Council's directives to meet the aspirations of Bahraini women in various economic fields.
I would like first to thank Her Royal Highness Sheikh Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa. The recognition today represents a huge achievement that will definitely push myself and my business forward, reminds us of what we have done and the work that is yet to be performed. We'll continue working hard to make sure that a Bahraini woman is always represented in the best manner, and to make sure that every time I wear this badge, I am well equipped to wear it.
Very honored to receive this award, and it's amazing. We're very lucky to get it among those amazing other women and other projects that have affected the whole market. it will definitely give us credibility with our customers and even more trust every time we start a new project and a new step. And we definitely feel that we have a bigger responsibility now to do better and to do more.
It's such an honor to receive this award. I think this is a huge motivation for us as entrepreneurs to give more to support the local community and to advance our businesses in the future.
His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa and His Royal Highness Prince Andrew, the Duke of York, today visited the UK Naval Support Facility, NSF, in Mina Salman. During the visit, His Highness Sheikh Isa highlighted the long-standing ties between Bahrain and the United Kingdom and noted the strength of bilateral cooperation across a wide range of areas, including defense. His Highness Sheikh Isa also highlighted that the UK Naval Support Facility, NSF, represents a key milestone in military cooperation between the two kingdoms. His Highness Sheikh Isa and His Royal Highness the Duke of York toured the facility and received briefings on a number of aspects related to the cooperation between the Royal Bahrain Naval Force and the British Royal Navy. The Representatives Council held its weekly meeting today, chaired by its speaker, Fawzia bint Abdullah Zainal. The session began with reviewing the two letters submitted by the chairman of the Shura Council on Education and the draft law that amends a number of the law's provisions on regulating the process of extracting sea sand and selling it. The council also reviewed the responses of ministers on the conditions of buildings and facilities in government schools. The number of housing applications and the housing ministry's strategic plan on reconstructing old neighborhoods in Imharag. The council also approved a number of proposals and draft laws and reviewed the committee's reports. Cabinet Affairs Minister Mohammed bin Ibrahim Al-Mtawa opened yesterday the art exhibition of Jabbar Al-Ghadban, Saeed Radhi and Abbas Yusuf, held under the patronage of the minister at Folk Art Space. The minister expressed admiration with the fine works of art and composition that reflect the outstanding levels of Bahraini artists. He praised the pioneering role of a folk art space in supporting artists in the kingdom. For their part, the artists expressed their thanks and appreciation to the Minister of Cabinet Affairs for his support to the artistic movement in Bahrain.
The exhibition I see here tonight is really the expression of the vibrant art scene in Bahrain, with its energy and also with so many different styles and inspirations. I find Bahrain a wonderful country, open and when it comes to art, always surprising. You always discover new aspects and new things about the Bahraini art scene and its traditions.
As part of the royal vision of promoting loyalty and values of nationalism, the Interior Minister General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa launched the national plan to promote the spirit of belonging to the nation and reinforce the values of nationalism today. The event was attended by ministers, senior officials, religious scholars, members of the Council of Representatives and the Shura Council, presidents of universities and institutes, heads of schools, representatives of human rights organizations, editors-in-chief of newspapers, businessmen, lawyers, doctors, owners of majalis and heads of sports clubs and youth centers. The Minister of Interior then delivered the following speech.
حيزا جغرافيا نعيش فيه فحسب، بل هو تاريخ المواطن وجذوره ومخزونه الثقافي وهوية وجوده، وإن تعزيز الانتماء الوطني وترسيخ قيم المواطنة ليست مفاهيم وجدانية الشعور والمعنى، بل إنها الضمانة الأساسية لتحقيق الاستقرار الوطني، ومن أهم الأسباب الموجبة التي دفعتنا لإعداد هذه الخطة الوطنية. أولاً، توجيهات سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه من خلال الخطابات السامية في العديد من المناسبات الوطنية التي نستخلص منها الحكمة والرؤى في تعزيز الانتماء وقيم المواطنة. والأمر الآخر هو أمانة المسؤولية الأمنية نحو المجتمع، وهي مسؤوليتنا، كما أنها الهدف الأسمى، لأننا مؤتمنون على أمن المجتمع حاضراً ومستقبلاً في إطار أمننا الوطني الذاتي. والسبب الآخر هو وفاءً وعرفاناً لعطاء الرجال الذين ضحوا بأرواحهم من أجل تحقيق الأمن والاستقرار. والحقيقة التي يجب أن لا تغيب عن أذهاننا هي استهداف الهوية الوطنية، وتحديداً من قبل إيران، سعياً منها لتكريس نهج التطرف الطائفي وزعزعة الاستقرار وبث الفتنة في المجتمع البحريني. ولا يسعني في هذا المقام إلا أن أعرب عن الشكر الجزيل لمجلس الوزراء الموقر برئاسة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة على إقراره للمبادرة واعتبارها خطة وطنية، وتشكيل اللجنة الوزارية لهذه الغاية بتاريخ 6 يناير 2019. والشكر موصول إلى صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد، نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء، على المساندة والدعم للمبادرة وإطلاق سموه عليها اسم بحريننا. كما أن كلمة الشكر واجبة إلى سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثل جلالة الملك للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة على مبادرات سموه الوطنية ورفع الروح المعنوية لدى الشباب وما حققه من إنجازات عززت الهوية الوطنية البحرينية في جميع المحافل الدولية. أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، الحضور الكريم، كانت البحرين وما زالت أعمق من فكرة الأرض والمكان، بل هي شرعية القيادة والتاريخ والمنجز والإنسان. فهويتنا البحرينية غنية بالقيم والعادات الموروثة من الآباء والأجداد والمستمدة من ديننا الإسلامي الحنيف، وإن الهوية الوطنية تشكل جزءاً أصيلاً من ملامح الشخصية البحرينية، حيث السماحة والحكمة والمروءة واحترام الآخر والتعايش، وهي صفة متأصلة بين قائد الوطن وشعبه. فالهوية البحرينية رسالتها عروبية وعقيدتها الإسلام والاعتدال، وهي محل اعتزاز قيادة سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، التي أفاضت القيم البحرينية الأصيلة على أبنائها في جميع مساحات الوطن لتصبح راسخة في حياة المواطن البحريني الذي يفاخر بهويته البحرينية الجامعة، متخذاً من وحدته الوطنية طريقاً نحو المجد والعلا. وإذا أردنا للبحرين أن تكون عصية على أي محاولات تريد المساس بأمن البحرين واستقرارها والعبث بسلمها الاجتماعي، فلا بد لنا أن نعبر خندق التطرف والطائفية بقلوب تؤمن بالانتماء والمحبة الوطنية. أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، الحضور الكريم، وفي الختام أود التأكيد على أن الانتماء والولاء للبحرين بقيادة جلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه ليس نصاً يحتمل الاجتهاد والتأويل ويختلف حوله التفسير، فالولاء والانتماء هوية وجود وقدوة حية تعيش في النفوس قبل النصوص، والمواطن البحريني شامخ بوطنه، معتز بقيادته، ومفتخر بهويته البحرينية العروبية الإسلامية. أسأل الله أن يوفقنا في تحقيق أهداف وغايات هذه الخطة الوطنية الطموحة، وأن يديم على البحرين أيام العزة والمنعة والرفعة في ظل قيادة سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، ودمتم سالمين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
مثل ما تعلمنا من
Then a film on the national plan was screened, which highlighted its progress from its inception to implementation, as well as its goals and initiatives. The event also focused on the plan, which was initiated by the Interior Minister and was then approved by the Cabinet, and a committee to follow up its execution was set up.
بحريننا بتظل شامخة بتاريخها العتيد وبحاضرها المجيد بسواعدنا وتفانينا وبحبتنا وتآخينا، فخلونا نشوف شلون بدت هالحكاية.
إن تعمق الإحساس بالولاء الوطني لدى أبناء الشعب البحريني يدفعنا إلى بذل المزيد لتعزيز هذا الشعور في وجدان ووعي الأجيال القادمة. فالأجداد والآباء حافظوا على الولاء للوطن والوفاء لقيادته وأخلصوا في هذا النهج، واليوم نكمل الدرب والمسيرة لنعمل على ترسيخ هذه القيم في نفوس الأجيال المتعاقبة. ليحفظ الله بحريننا.
الحضور الكريم، تمكن مجتمعنا في كل الأوقات أن يحافظ على نسيجه الواحد بقيمه النبيلة وبسمات الإنسان البحريني المتحضر المعروف بدماثة خلقه وسعة أفقه وبالتزامه وإخلاصه في خدمة وطنه والفخور بإرثه وهويته. وهذه هي الشخصية البحرينية الأصيلة التي نريد لها أن تواصل في تألقها وتفوقها من أجل بحرين المستقبل، فلنعمل جاهدين بالحفاظ عليها ونحصن بها سياجنا الوطني.
تعرفون ليش احنا متجمعين اليوم؟ خلينا نشوف اهداف وقيم خطتنا الوطنية.
حيث ستعمل هذه الخطة الوطنية من خلال الاهداف التالية: ترسيخ قيم الولاء والانتماء والتسامح والاعتدال والالتزام بالوحدة الوطنية، الاعتزاز بالهوية الخليجية والعربية والإسلامية والقيم الإنسانية، ربط الحاضر بالماضي وتعميق المعرفة بالتاريخ الوطني والاعتزاز بالإنجازات الحضارية، ترسيخ فهم الواجبات والمسؤوليات الوطنية.
ندش الدرب بكل الحب ونعلن أجمل الأيام، نحقق غالي الأحلام ونبدأ يد بيد دايم مثل جيلنا السابق إليم الجيلنا القادم، ونتواصل عشان تكون بلدنا أحلى بلد في الكون. نعم يا مملكة الأمجاد، نعم يا ديرة الأجداد، نعم يا بلادي يا البحرين، في وسط قلوبنا تبقين وولاؤنا رمز وبش نعتز، وقوتنا بوحدتنا يا ديرة تعني عزتنا.
After that, the Interior Minister launched the plan, the first national project that can be followed electronically. The national plan has 5 main streams covering all sections of society. Each stream has initiatives which will be implemented by various authorities under the supervision of the Executive Committee. In all, the plan has about 70 initiatives, each meant to achieve certain goals.
حبيت أشكركم وأشكركم من قلبي لما شفت في عينكم الأمل اللي خليتوه فينا، وجيتكم اليوم تحملنا مسؤولية كبيرة كبر حبكم وحبنا لبحريننا الغالية. أشكركم لأنكم زرعتوا بداخلنا الحب والعمل، إحنا بذرتكم اللي رويتوها بقيامكم، نوعدكم نكون قدها ونصون هالوطن ونحافظ عليه ونعلي شانه ونرفع صوتنا بفخر. عاشت بحريننا الغالية وعاشت بحريننا الغالية. بس بعد لازم نقول ونأكد وكلنا نردد، الماي واحد ولو كان اسمها بحرين، وتبقى هالبلد ملحنة ونظر هالعين، ونجحد خيرها وعكر صفوها واحد، نزله ويدوم صفا مايج يا البحرين.
نود بداية أن نبارك للجميع بعيد الوطن المجيد، وأن نحتفي بذكرى تأسيس الدولة البحرينية التي شهدت انطلاقتها المباركة قبل أكثر من 200 عام على يد الجد القائد أحمد الفاتح، وتشكلت هويتها الأصيلة على سواعد قادتها الكرام لتحافظ إلى يومنا هذا على مجدها الشامخ ونهجها الحضاري وقيمها المدنية، وبعون شعب وفي يرتقي بمكانتها وينطلق بها نحو مستقبلها الزاهر بإذن الله تعالى. ولا نجد أسمى من هذه المناسبة للتأكيد على تمسكنا بثوابتنا الوطنية القائمة على وحدة الصف وعمق الانتماء وسماحة التعايش التي تجعل البحرين بفضل من الله ويقظة أهلها منيعة على قوى الهد والفرقة، ومنطلقة نحو آفاق التنمية والبناء دون توقف.
The Bahraini community is built upon solid national fundamentals, which the national plan to promote the spirit of belonging to the nation and reinforce the values of nationalism is keen on strengthening through comprehensive initiatives in which various categories and authorities have participated. This comprehensive national plan is keen on establishing the noble citizenship values and respecting human rights, which reflects the goals of the reform project of His Majesty the King, which is considered the basis for growth and development in the kingdom.
The initiative of the Minister of Interior, Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, has witnessed a wide participation from various authorities, which affirm the importance of the plan and the important modern heritage the national identity represents that needs to be maintained and reinforced in the next generations. The National Plan includes 70 diverse and enriching initiatives that aim to work professionally to achieve the goals of maintaining the national identity.
His Imperial Highness Prince Akishino received today in Tokyo the governor of the Southern Governorate, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, on the occasion of his visit to Japan. His Imperial Highness welcomed His Highness Sheikh Khalifa, wishing him a good stay in Japan and noting the role of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa in strengthening the friendly relations between Bahrain and Japan, wishing Bahrain development and prosperity. He expressed thanks and appreciation for His Highness Sheikh Khalifa for his efforts on supporting the friendly relations between the two countries and developing them on all levels, including organizing the activities of the Japanese village in the Southern Governorate in cooperation with the Embassy of Japan in Bahrain. His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa noted that thanks to the support of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Bahrain made many local and international achievements and has become a global hub for hosting many important international events, initiatives, and activities that have made the Southern Governorate a tourist destination for visitors of Bahrain. Attending the meeting, Bahrain Ambassador to Japan, Ahmed Al-Dosiri, and the Ambassador of Japan to the Kingdom of Bahrain, Hadiki Ito. Within the framework of the official visit of the Southern Governor, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa to Japan, His Highness met with the Governor of Tokyo, Yuriko Koike. His Highness expressed pleasure with visiting Tokyo, adding that this visit is an opportunity to increase joint action and cooperation in various fields. He affirmed the interest of the Southern Governorate to learn about the experience of the Tokyo Prefecture in the field of the work of governance for its role on all levels, including security, social, economic, and development services to the state and members of the society. For her part, the Governor of Tokyo expressed her country's keenness to strengthen bilateral cooperation with the Kingdom of Bahrain and hold such meetings, noting that the visit of His Highness Sheikh Ali is the first visit of its kind to the governor from Bahrain to Japan. She added that the kingdom has taken steps towards development in various fields. Japan has introduced educational curricula on Bahrain in 35 schools in Japan. In a statement, the Southern Governor, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, said that the official visit to Japan was successful, highlighting the Japanese side's keenness on bolstering bilateral relations. His Highness noted the Southern Governor's keenness on providing the best services to citizens based on the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the support of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. He added that part of the Southern Governor's role is to increase partnerships with other friendly governors, including those in Tokyo and Kyoto, which stems from the two sides' keenness on bolstering relations in various fields. The capital government made an important achievement at the Arab level by winning the 2019 Arab Smart Government Shield Award, granted by the Arab Center for Intelligence Services and Innovation Technologies. The award is granted to Arab governments and official institutions whose applications and technologies are in accordance with the international standards of official websites. The governor's My Capital application won the award that was received by the governor of the capital, Sheikh Hisham bin Abd al-Rahman al-Khalifa, at a ceremony held yesterday evening in Egypt. On this occasion, Sheikh Hisham expressed pride in this honorable achievement, which reflects the support and directives of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, to develop the governance work by increasing communication with the residents to fulfill their needs. Sheikh Hashim bin Abd Rahman noted that the application creates an effective community partnership through an agreement between the capital government and a number of social activists in the governance villages and areas to follow up on residential needs and send them on the application. Temkin, in collaboration with the Supreme Council for Women, the SCW, announced the launch of the Temkin program to support women's participation in the labor market during a joint press conference held in Rafah. In the presence of the Council Secretary General Halal Ansari and Temkin CEO Dr. Ibrahim Janahi, Al Ansari noted that this program comes within the framework of cooperation and coordination between the SCW and Temkin to achieve the common objectives in supporting the Bahraini women in the labor market and in the fields of entrepreneurship and the private sector. She affirmed the Council's keenness to develop cooperation in line with the evolving needs and requirements of the labor market. Al Ansari gave a presentation on the SCW's goals to introduce specific initiatives for women in the labor market and to integrate their needs into comprehensive development programs. For his part, Dr. Ibrahim Janahi affirmed Temkin's support for the SCW's directives to support women's economic advancement and enhance their presence in various national development fields.
Temkin has always provided financial assistance and grants to female entrepreneurs within the private sector, in addition to equal opportunities to get job opportunities in the private sector. We have supported wages and training of females within the private sector. And today we are looking to create a comprehensive strategy program whereby we can highlight the support Temkin has provided to the segment and provide assistance, guidance and tools to further promote the contribution of women in the local economy and to provide success stories to inspire women to contribute more going forward.